Right. Well, that saying, be the architect of your truth, is profound enough to spend some time on, because if you have a truth that, hey, I'm not, I don't have enough money. And if you start to look at how you respond around money, for example, you might say, oh, they have an ungodly amount of money and, you know, they're filthy rich and they, you know, and you find yourself catching yourself saying, oh, I don't have enough money. We don't have enough money. We can't afford that. You know what? You've basically instilled a truth in your mind that money is negative. You will gravitate to your truth. So if you were the architect of your truth, what if you made it up your mind that you would surround yourself with positive attributions around money, that you had a certain amount of intention around money? You know, I suggest if you're struggling right now, keep a $100 bill in your pocket at all times, right? You always have money. I have money. I love money. You know, do they have an ungodly amount? No, they have a fantastic amount of money. They have a wonderful amount of money. You know, changing your mind about that topic. Or would it be relationships? Oh, I can't trust men. I can't this. I can't that. The Me Too generation. All this stuff is piling on this. And then all of a sudden this truth becomes something that's, you know, I think the word is deleterious, you know, where you all of a sudden can't trust any men or something like that. You know, we talked about money, but how about finance? How about, you know, your status in life? How about the job that you could do? How about becoming a doctor? You know, whatever that truth is, if you really pay attention, you wait a second, I'm gravitating to the truth that I have in my subconscious mind. So to change your mind is way more effective when you apply the emotional quotient to that. So let's go back to money, for example. Instead of just thinking that money, imagine the feeling of freedom, what it feels like to have money. What if it, what would it feel like the texture of an award, or holding a piece of paper that says you own your house mortgage free, you know, something that, you know, the senses, what would the champagne taste like? So to bring in the five senses and then the emotion attached to that not only supports the truth, it solidifies a new truth. And it's just like turning a bucket of water blue. It's one drop of dye at the time. It doesn't turn blue right away. You got to whoop and then whoop and then later, eventually that truth, that dark blue bucket of water, it's blue. That truth is in fact, over time, instilled in a way exactly by your design. You are the architect of your truth.